When we're dealing with markets, one of the assumptions that we initially make is that nothing changes within the market. This is an entirely unrealistic assumption because, as we've noticed, if you pay attention to the news on even a monthly basis, you know things in the world are changing very regularly. For our model to be useful, our model of demand and supply, we have to be able to incorporate changes into the model. When things change in the world around us, things inevitably change within the model. But when things change in the world around us, they affect the model in different ways, depending upon whether those world changes cause buyers or sellers to alter their behavior. We call these things shifters, things that shift the behavior of either the buyer or the seller. For example, let's say after you graduate from Robert Morris, you end up getting a much better job, and so your income goes up. Well, that's going to shift the amount of things that you're able to afford. It's not a change in price, so we're no longer changing along the demand curve. This is something that fundamentally shifts the entire curve. So now you can buy more of everything at every possible price. This is an increase in demand, and we signal this by showing a rightward shift in the demand curve. Now let's say you lose your job. This would cause your income to fall, and you would buy fewer things at every possible price. This is called a decrease in demand, or a leftward shift in demand. There are many things that cause demand to change. Anything that will change the buyer behavior will cause the demand curve to shift, whether it's a change in tastes, the way that people view the world, the way that people view style, whether it's a change in your income, a change in the availability of a substitute good. So a good that might replace something that you're looking at buying, if that becomes more affordable, that's going to change your demand. If, for example, the affordability of electric cars changes, that changes your demand for traditional gasoline-powered cars. Anything that changes the buyer behavior, it could be taxes, it could be any number of things, will shift the demand curve. But the one thing that doesn't shift demand is a change in price. Change in price only changes the amount that you want to buy, the amount that you're able to buy, along a single specific demand curve. Anything else that alters buyer behavior moves the entire curve. If it increases demand, it shifts it to the right, and if it decreases demand, it shifts to the left. Similarly, on the supply side of things, anything that causes business behavior to change, that causes the ability and willingness of the supplier to sell their product, if that changes, it's going to shift the supply curve. So if there's more competition in a market, there's more sellers in a market, that increases the amount of product available on the market. Or if a competitor gets bought out, or if a competitor goes bankrupt, that decreases the number of sellers and it decreases supply. Typically, the rule of thumb on supply shifting is this. If it changes the cost of doing business, whether you're talking about taxes, regulations, the cost of your resources, the availability of your resources, new technology, anything that causes the cost of doing business to go up or down, that's going to shift the supply curve. Now, the tricky part with supply is understanding which direction is an increase and which is a decrease. Your best bet is to always go with right and left. If the supply curve shifts to the right of its original position, that's an increase in supply, because what that means is that at every given price, you're willing and able to supply more of the product. A shift to the left is a decrease in supply, because at every given price, you're willing and able to supply less of the product. If you think about things in terms of right and left, it's much easier to understand what happens to the curves, both demand and supply. Now, why is this important? It's important because if we want to be able to predict something with our model, we need to understand what happens to the supply curve or the demand curve, and then subsequently what happens to the equilibrium. This is a three-step process known as comparative statics. What we're doing is we're basically comparing two equilibrium. So, when something changes in the world, we want to be able to figure out what that's going to do to the market price and the market quantity. In order to do that, we take three steps. The first step is to decide when this event takes place, which curve, demand or supply, will shift. If it affects the buyer, it changes demand. If it affects the seller, it changes supply. The second step is to determine which direction does the curve shift. Does it increase to the right or decrease to the left? And then finally, step three, we find the new equilibrium and compare it to the old one. And we have to do two things. We first of all have to say, does price go up or down? And does output or quantity go up or down? So if you look at the graph, what we're looking at here is an initial equilibrium. And then there is an event that takes place that causes one of the curves to shift. The event in this case is a new tax on business. We'll call it a corporate profit tax. Now what we have to do is go through our comparative static process. The first question is, which curve will shift? So think about it for a second. And if you said supply, this is a tax on business and it causes the cost of doing business to increase. So supply shifts. The second question is, which direction does it shift? If you said it shifts to the left, this is causing the cost of business to go up, and that will subsequently mean there is less business being done. So the curve shifts to the left as supply decreases. Finally, we want to identify what happens to price and quantity. When supply decreases and demand stays the same, price goes up. Additionally, quantity goes down. You should be able to sketch this out on a piece of paper and identify what's going on. If you want to understand how the supply and demand model works, this is a great method of practice. Think to yourself a potential event and see which curve shifts, which direction does it shift, and then what happens to price and quantity. And then ask yourself, of course, does this make sense? If taxes go up and prices go down, that shouldn't make sense to you because it's getting more expensive to do business. The price shouldn't be falling in the marketplace. So use common sense when you look at these and practice with the graphs to make sure that you can see how the changes occur.